none of these teams have had an opportunity really to do too much so far in the competition. So we said one of them, I think, was WinterWolves, bound themselves up against Chiefs and got taken out 16-3, and the other one had a forfeit win. So wins are great. Flash is going over to the B bomb site. It's going to be a B stack. All bar one of the players from the CTs are here. Hair's going to go down. Willy Case picks up the first kill. Steve might be able to get a headshot or two here if he's careful. Iron picks up one. Ghost picks up one. And great use of the USPs here from Jam Gaming. Easy, easy round one, Elfish guy. They picked that one up without losing a player.
Yeah, it's a really nice stack coming out there from Jam. Obviously, a lot of the time on the pistol round here on Cobble, you'll tend to see the terrorists head towards the B site. And obviously, Jam well aware of that, stacking four over towards that side. It worked out perfectly for them, getting all kills and not losing a single player for their troubles. And they've managed to buy up here a few UMPs, or a couple of UMPs, and a couple of rifles there as well as P90. So a reasonable buy coming out here. They've got, you know, the stopping power if WinterWolves were to buy up on armor, and also that extra cash if they were going up against an eco. The result is they're going to be up against that armor, so those rifles, also the UMP to an extent, are going to be quite good.
Yeah, UMP quite good up against the old armor, so we'll see how it goes. It's not a bad buy at all for Jam Gaming, but certainly that force to a degree coming out here from WinterWolves. And first kill of the round going to go out to Majestic as Ghost gets picked up. Steve going to return that one with the M4. Envy pulls out. He picks up one. Tech 9 going strong. Willy KS picks up one as well. He's tanked up a little bit. Bomb plant going to go down. No. Willy KS picks up that one. He just needs to turn around because Rex is behind him, and he's going to find himself an easy kill with the pistol. He should be able to pick up the P90 as well. He's the last player left. No, he's going to back away. There we go. P90 is out. Iron on 4% HP, so if he sees him, it's going to come down to a 1-on-1, which it is. And they know where each other are. Won't get an opportunity to get the bomb plant down, I suspect. So Molly going to go out to the left, force Regs over to the right. 30 seconds on the clock. Cruden's going to try and back away and just, I think he knows where the bomb is here, and he's just trying to keep the player off the bomb without having to get into that 1v1 duel. But up behind him is Regs, and he's got the P90. We'll see him. Cruden swings around, picks him up. Great work. Saves the day. But that's a pretty good force there coming out from WinterWolves. Nevertheless, good.
Yeah, certainly is 2-0 already here for Jam. But as you mentioned, lots of guns out of the hands. Still, Jam is going to have enough money to buy up here. And actually, they're going to go for some SMGs. Obviously, WinterWolves going to be using only those pistols. No armor at all in this round. So pretty reasonable round here for Jam from an economic standpoint. They shouldn't be losing too many guns, and they've got a couple of SMGs that will allow them to get that bonus. So as I say that, though, Iron is going to be the first one to go down. Luckily for Jam, he's the only player that didn't really buy up a weapon. He had a P250, I think, from memory. So that's not too bad of a loss for Jam, at least. But still, this is how you start to slowly but surely lose the eco rounds. You lose that first kill, and then someone else pushes like Cruden, almost gets taken down there, and giving away that rifle. But luckily for him, he is able to take down Majestic. But that could have gone a whole lot worse for Jam.
Certainly can. Bomb, we can see, is in hall, sort of. And we did see one player coming around from the CTs, but I think they're going to back off. And with a minute on the clock, the T-Sign needs to decide here what they want to do. They've got a split on at the moment. Steve in a reasonable spot here as well with that P90. Envy going to try and push up through over into drop. He actually picks up Steve, though. Nice little headshot from him. So that's going to perhaps even up the odds for the T-Sign, who at the moment only have pistols here. And it looks like it's still, with 40 seconds on the clock, going to be towards the B-bomb site. Only two CT players over there. But Cruden in a fantastic position to clear out pairs. He picks him up very, very quickly. Evens up the player count. And with those weapons, they're looking like they're in a pretty good spot here for Jam Gaming. Rex should be able to pick up Willy KS. Willy KS did take out Envy in the meantime. 2-on-2 here. Rex now going to drop down, swing around to his left. Oh, great swing. Picks him up. Picks up the M4 as well. And now it's only Ghost remaining. 10 seconds on the clock. Going to try and get this bomb plant down. Ghost can defend his bomb plant. He just needs to stay back and not duel in the 1v1. He should be safe here. And they will win the round even. Jam Gaming taking that one out very, very close. Closer than it should have been, Elfish Guy. And if perhaps if the Wolves had just pushed a little bit earlier, they would have been able to pick that one up.
That was a really sloppy round coming out from Jam. They all sort of pushed on their own, didn't have anyone to back each other up, and as a consequence, lost four guns. And really, they were in a position where they should have lost the round. Ghost, luckily for Jam, coming up there with the goods, but certainly didn't really deserve to win that round there. WinterWolves doing a lot of economic damage to Jam as well, and now they're going to come in here with a fantastic buy with the four AKs and, of course, the M4 that they managed to pick up. Now they're just going to try and roll over this B-bomb site, which it looks certainly like they're going to be able to do. The flashbang's coming out, slowing things down. They're all stuck still up on plat, and the Molotov will come across as well. Steve just spotting out on towards the A site isn't going to see anyone, and I think that's really going to be giving away the fact that the majority of Jam are over towards this B site here. Envy is going to spot out Iron and takes him down with a nice headshot from that AK. Bruden is going to go and get a trade across onto Extinct. As I say that, though, Envy is going to pick up Willy KS as well. So things looking fantastic here for WinterWolves as they make their way on towards the statue. Cruden is going to grab one. Steve as well grabs another, but Envy coming in from behind on the flank will pick up Cruden, and the bomb is going to go down here. Now Steve has the job to do, retaking with the orb.
Yeah, that's not necessarily the position you want to be in, but he's not, like, it's not a terrible spot. There's no one sitting in close. He just needs to check these angles and perhaps even pick up this first shot. Envy in a great spot, though. Oh, that would have been close for Vlad as well. I'm surprised
wow.
they didn't
okay.
line up. Two sick shots there coming out from Steve. And he picks that one up. Honestly, I thought that Winter Gaming were in a fantastic position to pick that one up. They'd had three, oh, I suppose the pistol round was average, but two very good follow-up rounds, even if they hadn't won. And, to be fair, I thought perhaps on the first gun round that they were in a good spot. But Jam Gaming and certainly Steve saving the day there with that AWP. Some very, very sick frags and putting WinterWolves on the back foot here. They will buy up again. However, I guess all those ecos in a row, or all those, they didn't necessarily eco, but they didn't spend all their cash. They managed to pick up AKs once again. But they really, really need to win this round.
Yeah, they certainly do. They've had a couple of opportunities to actually close one, and it doesn't matter how close you get. Eventually, you need to start getting rounds on the board, and WinterWolves, if they're not able to get this one, then I don't know what's going wrong, because they've got those two entry frags. This one should be in the bag, but we've seen Jam come from behind twice in a row. Whether or not they can do it again is going to be the question. Majestic will take down Willy KS. Extinct managed to take down Iron up there on the balcony as well, and surely, Sandman, this one can't go in the favor of Jam.
I think it's a little bit too much to ask for Ghost here, as he does start to back away. Perhaps going to try and find himself an X. No, he's not even going to bother with that. He's just going to check out the T-side spawn. So very, very good round here from WinterWolves, and I think this is definitely what the boys needed. They've saved almost all their armor. They've taken like less than 50 damage across the whole team there. As I said, that Majestic does get picked out trying to poke into Ghost. But, it's a good round for the guys, and it's going to put them back in the game. Score's going to be 4-1. Do you like T-side on Cobble, Jordan? It's, like, the map's quite wide, isn't it? The rotations
it's,
can be...
Yeah, well, I mean, at the moment, Cobble is a little bit more T-sided than CT. Not hugely so, but... it certainly favors the T side. Obviously, the rotation is quite difficult for Jam, and it's quite long as well. It takes a while to get from the A site to the B site. So, and it's also quite easy just to get straight in towards that B site. So, obviously, WinterWolves, I mean, 4-1 down is not so bad at the moment, but they'd be expecting for something a little bit better than that. And whether or not they can turn things around here in the later stages of this first half is going to be the important question, because they need to hit something like at least 7 rounds here on their T side.
Yeah, you want to make the most of it. Iron in a reasonable spot here, but of course he only does have that CZ, which is good for essentially 1.5 kills, I suspect. So you really do need to make the most of that one. It is a B stat coming out here from WinterWolves, which is not surprising at all. Iron just trying to poke. He's a little bit far back. Perhaps we'll see whether he'll get the spray down as they do. Push out Envy at the front here. Does manage to hit Iron in the head. He was down to 8 HP though. Smoke going to come out. Willy KS tries to pick up one, but he's going to get taken down as well. Six shot through the smoke, and five players still remaining as they pull back. I don't know how this is going to work out. Cruden going to pick up a free kill there, and they didn't push out at the start. Only Steve here on the B-bomb side at the moment. We'll see how this plays out. He needs to pick up one free frag, wherever that may be. And he does as Paz goes down. It is now 2-3. Two plays here. Very, very tagged up for the WinterWolves. Will Extinct pick up a kill? He does. Steve going to go down. Cruden, the last player left and in no real position to do anything of consequence. And the bomb plant going to go down. WinterWolves looking to pick up their second round in a row. Get themselves back onto the scoreboard with a 4-2. Slowly starting to chip away. That was almost closer than it needed to be, though.
Yeah, I mean, all these ecos here, or all the anti-ecos, rather, from all these both these teams have been a little bit sketchy, probably giving up a little bit more than they should. This round, I think you could say, is a pretty par score for WinterWolves, but it was certainly, as you mentioned, very close to being a very bad situation. You can see all those players, how low they are. All, you know, only one or two shots from a pistol there. So they need to be a little bit more careful on their anti-ecos. They're not giving away so many guns and so many kills and all that sort of thing. In the end, it is going to be Cruden, though, saving that AK into the next round here for Jam. That's going to be pretty important because they're going to have to be on another eco here, and maybe he'll be able to do something with it and pick up a couple of sneaky frags and get themselves into the round here for Jam.
Yeah, look, I don't know. It's kind of a... They haven't spent any money at all, so... Just Cruden on the AK. He'll be able to keep that one, I think. Did he fill off his armor? I'm not even sure, to be honest. But we'll see how the boys can go. A pretty good round here, I suspect, going to come out from WinterWolves. A lot of close angles here on B side. The USP's not so great. We'll see if they can find themselves a free kill. Only one USP, though, to be fair. The other boys have changed up their pistols. So, we'll see what's going to happen, but again, just slowly holding, and no A site pushes as of yet. Though for sure, we haven't seen plays come through, but not much going on in the way of planning over there.
Yeah, I mean, you don't often see it. Generally speaking, B is the site of choice for most teams. Obviously, they like to change things up and head towards A occasionally, and it does look like that might be a possibility here for WinterWolves at the moment as they are starting to rotate across. Obviously, Jam here really only have the pistols to work with. They do have that one AK that I guess is the threat there for WinterWolves, but as soon as WinterWolves find that AK, they're going to know that they're reasonably safe and that they can sort of just charge in there with the AKs and take everyone out. Steve goes down, but the AK is still alive here for Jam. As I mentioned that, though, Ghost is going to go down. Iron finds one, gets two, almost lining up the third there with the pistol, but not quite going to be enough. Still, a reasonably okay eco there coming out from Jam. They drop a couple of guns. WinterWolves, though, will be happy with that. They pick up their third round, and they keep three guns on the board. So, good result for, I guess, both teams, really.
Yeah, WinterWolves starting to actually make some bank here. Only Pairs looking looking low on the cash, but the rest of them actually looking pretty well. So, a pretty good position, to be fair, after the last three rounds in a row that they've had. Well, obviously, that's where you'd expect them to be, but considering the game started poorly, and they lost that first gun round as well. They've come back relatively strongly. Bomb is over in towards Halls and the B side, but three players from WinterWolves are just starting to push towards the A side instead. We have Iron in a great spot, but Extinct is having none of it. Great double coming out from Cruden, picking up two. Extinct and Regs both going down. This is what Jam needs if they want to come back and get this game perhaps a little bit on even kill, even if the scoreboard is in their favor. The last three rounds haven't been, and the cash certainly isn't as well. So they really, really need to win this round if they don't want to let WinterWolves start pulling this one away and find themselves in a little bit more of a precarious position. Steve holding back, Cruden holding on the left of the site as well. So two players here up against the two who are going to try perhaps in a push down alley, and the bomb going to come up through water as well. So Pairs and Majestic going to swing around the corner here and try and find themselves a kill. We'll see how the guys from Jam Gaming are going to go. Willy Chaos needs to come across in the interim, and 3-2 at the moment. It should be 3-3 as it pushes across, but Steve goes down. Whoa. Great double from Cruden again. Cruden having a very sick half there, and or side even, and picks up four kills, almost picks up the fifth Elfish guy for the ace, but great, yeah. Spray coming out from that M4.
I thought that was going to go all pear-shaped there for Jam, because you could see Willy Chaos coming in from the connector area. Only had a Mag 7 to work with, and really the majority of WinterWolves were quite a long way away from him, so the Mag wasn't going to necessarily be as effective as it could have been. But Kruder managed to get enough damage across and obviously got those double kills, or got that double kill as well, which really shut the round down there in the favor of Jam. So I guess a little bit lucky that he was able to get that, given that his teammate, his crossfire setup was already down. But in the end, five on the board there for Jam, and they're going to have a four stack towards B. A push comes out on towards the T-spawn from Iron. Envy is going to punish that, and that's not too good at all for Jam. Now down in a four versus five situation.
No, it's not great, but WinterWolves pushing out here. We will see all four players now stacked on this B site for Jam. And I don't know, is it time to rotate? It looks like it might be. Are they going to try and swing through drop? Or are they going to swing all the way back through halls and perhaps around the A site? Majestic does go down, though, lurking across on the B site, and it looks like a rotation is in order, but we will see a couple of players from Jam heading over onto the A site themselves. So they've managed to play this relatively well on the CT side and just trying to find themselves, just playing it carefully, I suppose. One of those players being Willy KS only has the Mag 7, and he's not in a great spot for that. So Cruden's going to have to show some strong plays once again. He's in the spot to do it. He's sitting down in alley, and he can pick up one, perhaps two. They know where he is, but they're all on your right-hand side as they push through to the main area of A site. Regs takes out two. It is now only Regs up against Ghost and Steve. Ghost is on the far side. Steve is on the... Regs is on the site, sorry. And, I don't know, man. He's got to get the bomb here. And Ghost pushes across, it's not going to happen. Runs up.
Yeah, just running himself out of time. I mean, he had to be careful, but at a certain point, you're going to lose the round anyway, so you just got to hightail it.
Yeah, I don't know, man. I'm not so keen on that. But the rotations were in order. There were two players from Jam coming across, so I don't think he perhaps could have got away or even gotten a bomb plant down there. Again, Cruden getting some good frags. He's going okay, not having a bad game.
Yeah, certainly not. He's doing the legwork at the moment for Jam. 13 and 6, the rest of his team, no one above 6 frags. So he's certainly, I guess, the standout at the moment for Jam. And needs to keep that up because, obviously, they're looking pretty strong here. 6 and 3 on their CT side is quite a reasonable scoreline here. But they'd want to turn this into something like a 10-5 from this point at the very least.
Yeah, after a good few rounds, Jam has certainly turned this around on WinterWolves and starting to put the boot in, I suppose, because they're not looking very healthy. They haven't purchased all that much at all for this round. Economically, not great. Ghost picks up one. Will he be able to get second? He should, but he doesn't. Reg's going to combine with the damage extinction and takes it down. Steve onto Regs. Majestic picks up one. Willy KS finishes him off. Actually, Majestic picking up Envy, that's not great. You don't want those team kills. And another round going out to Jam Gaming. We'll see. They picked up the last three in succession. And a bye coming out finally for the WinterWolves. Five rounds left in this half, Elfish Guy. They really want to pick up at least four of those.
They certainly do. I'm just having a sneaky look at that chicken bugging out. I don't know if you got that on your screen, but that was interesting.
And he was doing the chicken dance. Give him a break.
Look at it.
Shuffle.
It's just, it's, I think it's done. I don't even know. Anyway, regardless, we're going to see WinterWolves once again sort of having their little bit of a stack over towards the B site, seeing if they can get something as someone pushes up to plat. Envy there with the job, with the orb. Does manage to tag up Steve, but not getting the kill. And I think that's the important thing here for Jam, because the orb in the hands of Steve there, he's a one-shot kill anyway. Doesn't really matter how low HP he is. He's still going to be effective.
Majestic going to pick up a kill onto Ghost. Does get tagged up quite a bit, down to only 2 HP. They're going to swing back around. The bomb is down here in a hall still. Oh, nice nade coming out from Willy KS. Going to pick up the last 2 hit points onto Majestic and cleaning him up, I suppose. And they were perhaps going to rotate, but it looks like the bomb is going to start making its way again back towards the B site and perhaps into B main here. They've got 45 seconds, Elfish Guy. They should be able to push out. Maybe Jam has over-rotated back to A-side. We'll see how this one goes. Only Steve on the site. They now know where the T's are. Steve's pushed back onto Rock. He will get one, but in the end gets picked up by Regs. The bomb plant should go down here. 3 on to 3. Only two of those players are on the site, though, with the last player swinging around through through halls, and he might be here late. We'll soon find out. Perhaps he's going to come through, drop and get a couple of frags from behind. He does. Pruden going to go down. Envy going to go down as well. Willa KS picks up two very quickly. It is now up to Extinct, and what can he do here to keep these guys off the bomb? He might be able to find himself one kill. They line up, but he doesn't manage to do all that much. The defuse is going down. Line up. Why do you... Oh, man. You got to be so careful. Very, very easy double there coming out from Extinct with two very quick headshots. And the round there going to go out finally to the WinterWolves.
Yeah, that was very nicely played from Extinct. Knew exactly where the bomb was planted, knew where he had to be in the position to be able to pick up the bomb planter. And really, I think if he had just got the bomb planter, that would have been enough. But in the end, he was able to pick up both the kills there. So even better for Jam in the end. For WinterWolves, rather, in the end. So another round on the board for them. Jam probably should have been able to close that one out. But regardless, goes in the favor of WinterWolves. And now we'll see whether or not they can follow up here with a second round in a row, which is basically what they need to do so they don't get their economy reset. Otherwise, Jam's going to close this half out with a pretty reasonable scoreline.
Yeah, it's not a great buy, but certainly Jam's is less than ideal as well. So we'll come down, I suspect, to the first couple of kills of the round. Reg's going to take out Iron, and four players left on the CTs. Only one of those, though, in Willa KS is holding over on the A site. The rest are stacked here towards B, so that's not terrible. We'll see whether WinterWolves decide to rotate or not. They're coming back towards B now, but slowly but surely, a minute left on the clock. Steve just trying to find himself a nice little defensive position and perhaps find himself a free kill or two. As I said, three players here over on B. The bomb does start to come through B main. They're going to push out onto Terrace in a second. We'll see what's going to happen. Next, going to come out. Extinct just trying to get anyone out of drop, perhaps, as they come out onto Terrace if they know or suspect someone is over there into Coop. We'll see if they can kill up. Pruden going to get tagged up massively by that nade. Easy onto the side here at the moment. Pairs picks up a kill on Cruden. Steve going to get tagged up as well. He picks up one. Extinct and Regs take out Ghost and Steve. And it's now only Willa KS, who was on the complete other side of the map. He's got a mag 7 offish guy, but I don't think he's going to pick up 4.
Yeah, he's probably just going to look for exits here, and that's not a bad decision at all. The mag 7 going to give him a little bit of extra cash on top of a normal weapon. And he's found himself in a pretty reasonable spot here as well if he does decide to do that. There's going to be a couple exiting through... maybe not. It looks like they're heading back in towards the B side and going out through the connector. So they're going to be safe from Willy. And he is going to be able to keep that Mag 7 heading into the next round as well. So not too bad for him either. But Jam, they'll probably be keen to get something like 9 rounds here. If they can pick up another couple, I think they'll be pretty happy with themselves. And someone hiding in the toilet.
Yeah, just taking a quick pit stop there. You know? I can't understand. It's all good. But Jam, 7 and 5. Look, it's okay. Willy KS will be keeping that mag 7. He doesn't have all that much money on him, and he's going to use it all up on utility. The guys from WinterWolves, looks like Majestic going to keep that Galil as well. 4 AKs, 1 Galil. Not terrible. The rest of the buy is pretty good. Iron picks up a free kill there with his AWP onto Pairs, which is definitely how you want to start the round if you are the CT side. And again, 4 on B, 1 towards A. But look, it's not that bad here, actually, for Jam. This is pretty good considering... I guess two AWPs isn't a bad buy, though, is it, really? Even if only one of them has armor.
Yeah, I mean, the economic situation they're in does make it a little bit interesting. But if you can make it work, it's not too bad. You basically need to make it work, though. Yeah, otherwise, your economy is just going to be shattered. So,
yeah,
a little bit risky buy coming out there for Jam, but at the moment, it's working out. Still 4 alive, though, for WinterWolves, so they definitely have a pretty reasonable opportunity heading in towards this round as well. But there you go. Iron's going to pick up another one. I think you might have spotted out Majestic as well. Isn't going to get the kill there onto Regs, but regardless, still doing a pretty good job with that AWP. And now Cruden is going to be there with the backup. The flashbang's coming across. He does actually flash himself, but he'll get a pop flash going in towards mid there. Picks up a double kill for himself. As you mentioned, Cruden doing a lot of work for Jam here at the moment. And that's just showing up once again in this round as he's just decimating WinterWolves as they try to push up mid. And now only one player left here. It's Envy. in a 1v3, and I think he might have been heard by Iron. He's been spotted at the very least, and he is going to be taken down. So a very good round coming out there from Iron. A triple kill, or, well, three kills for him with the AWP, and they do manage to keep both of those AWPs heading into the next round as well.
Yeah, that round really couldn't have played out any better, I think, for Jam. Iron taking the risk with the AWP, poking early along into sidewalk and finding himself a kill, and then again into ladder room. And so, you know, that worked out. That worked out really well. He's going to try and do it again. And look, it's an A push here coming out from the T side. So this isn't terrible positioning for the CTs in Jam Gaming. Flash out going to go from Cruden, and we'll see if they're going to rush it or not. They certainly will. Tech-9's most of the way, at least. Tech-9's an armor, it is. And tagged up a little bit, but onto the site. Cruden in a good spot. He is Flash, though. Picks up one. Willy KS takes out Majestic as well. Cruden perhaps going to swing around, find himself a kill. He needs to hold that spray. He does. Swaps across to his pistol. And Pear's going to go down for the final kill of the round. Jam Gaming 9-5 as we head into the very last round of this first half. And as we talked about this before, but I think Jam feeling pretty good. Nine is not too bad here on CT.
No, certainly not. And they've been looking quite good in the last two rounds. They didn't lose a single player in the previous one. Iron dropped down to 1 HP, but that's enough to keep your gun into the next round, and that's what they did. So Jam, they managed to keep that double AWP set up for the last few rounds, and they've been looking strong with it. So you could expect that they might be able to turn this one into a 10-5 half, which would be pretty fantastic on their CT side here on Cobble.
Yeah, like it's definitely what you want to see. To be fair, they had the first four rounds essentially not gifted to them, but it's an easy way to start the game, isn't it, if you can pick up the first four. To be fair, WinterWolves haven't done bad to come back from that. But if Jam comes out with 10 rounds, it's going to be a difficult second half for WinterWolves on CT. They certainly will need to show us what they're made of if they want to bring this one back. Again, starting to try and find a way to execute onto this B-bomb site. The bomb, again, left in halls. Lots of smoke down, but they will be able to get out here onto Terrace. Regs just wants to find himself a kill. Extinct picks up one, swings around the corner, should be able to get it in a second. He does. Very, very good work from him. And Regs does pick up Ghost as well. So only Iron here with the AWP. Five players left. He might as well make the effort, but it's not going to happen. 9-6 is the score heading into the change of sides. And Jam Gaming looking okay, but WinterWolves definitely needed that round.
Yeah, those entries from Extinct just looked very nice for WinterWolves. They certainly needed it, as you mentioned. Six rounds on their T side. I don't know if that's going to be enough here on Cobble, but we'll see what they do turning over into their CT side. Obviously, if Jam can do it, WinterWolves can do it as well. But certainly, in my opinion, this match is favored towards Jam. Heading over to the easier side with a round advantage as well. Should put themselves in a pretty good position here to close this one out, but we'll have to wait and see whether or not they're going to be able to do that.
Yeah, no, definitely a great spot to be, and all these games are important. Do we? What were the scores from before? I think for did WinterWolves lose a game and Jam had
a they lost 16-3 to Chiefs, and Jam didn't play because of a forfeit win. So
WinterWolves definitely need to pick this one up if they want to feel like they're going to stay alive in the competition, or certainly give themselves the best chance. It is a stack towards the A bomb site coming out from WinterWolves, and we'll see how they're going to go. From coming out from Jam, even the WinterWolves spread out pretty evenly across the map, and one player here in Willy K is going to get picked up very, very quickly as he does come in to drop. Envy going to go down as well, and Steve picks up a kill in a return. Extinct going down. Steve with a great second kill, perhaps being able to get a bomb plant down here is Cruden. He will, and good position here for the whole three on to under two, though to be fair, it is two with 100 HP on both. We'll see what the boys from the CT side can do. Still, 3-2 is the player matchup, and Cruden going to need to swing around if he wants to defend. He doesn't. Going to get picked up. Pairs with a great double, and the defuse going to come out here. Fantastic retake coming out from the WinterWolves. Going to pick up that very important second half pistol round here. Elfish guy going to bring the scores back to 7-9. And this is what they need to do if they want to bring this one back.
That certainly looked quite good for WinterWolves to start off there. They got the two picks at the very start of the round as Jam were trying to get in towards that A side, and then subsequently lost quite a few kills and found themselves in a 2v3 situation where it turned back into the favour of Jam, and then all of a sudden straight back in the favour of WinterWolves. So a very backwards and forwards round coming out there, but WinterWolves coming out superior, which is what they needed to do given that they were down, and this should lead them to another couple of rounds in a row, but we'll have to see. Jam have decided to force up into this one. They've got the armor and the Tech Nines, and they're heading towards the B bomb site, so this could be a little bit deadly here. WinterWolves need to be careful.
They certainly do. 5 Tech Nines across the board, armor and almost a helmet for everybody. They're stacked here, ready to pile out onto the B site. Majestic sees one, he picks up a free kill. Envy takes that one until Cruden, going to return one, but onto the site they should be able to still. No, another great kill from Majestic as he finally gets taken down, goes to the last player left, needs to go up, grab the bomb. He's on 29 HP, but he'll probably get picked up from behind if he's not very, very careful. There's two players to his right through the smoke. He wants to try and get the bomb plant down at least, but Pear's in a great position to pick up the kill. He gets it. And another WinterWolves round, going to even things up. 8-9 even. Getting closer. And that's how they want to start this game, Elfish Guy.
Yeah, they would have wanted to start this half strong, and they certainly have done that. But Jam, yeah, that last round, I think they might be a little bit disappointed they didn't manage to at least get a bomb plant there, because they invested a reasonable amount in that round, and they did get 3 kills, which is quite decent up against WinterWolves, but then obviously didn't manage to get that bomb plant. So I think they would have wanted a little bit more out of that round than what they got. In the end, though, it wasn't to be, and they are going to have to just rush up mid here with those pistols. They've actually got themselves a reasonable positioning here. Need to be careful, though, that Regs doesn't pick him off. It is going to be Cruden going down there to start us off. Willy KS, though, in a very nice spot. He's going to pick up one, looking for a second. Won't be able to get it just yet, but Iron is going to take down Regs. The bomb dropped on the A site perfectly for him. He's going to be able to plant that one without any troubles at all. So Jam, despite having a poorer buy than the previous round, are actually going to get more done here as they get that bomb down. It's obviously going to be defused here by WinterWolves, but the little bit of extra cash in the bank is not going to hurt Jam at all.
Yeah, certainly won't. Reg's a little bit unlucky there. It's always when you swap to your nade, Elfish Guy, that someone pokes around the corner when you're in a great spot, as he was. Yeah. And finds himself taken out. 9-9 is the score. Everyone should be able to buy up now. And certainly the case here. Willy K is the last one to buy. He should have enough. He does. AKs, 4 AKs, one AWP. And we'll see what Jam can do here, because WinterWolves has pulled this game back slowly but surely. We are even, and from here on out, we just first team to get another 7 rounds. So we'll see what the guys can do. Again, it looks like a stack towards A, but the bomb is in hall. So we'll see what Jam Gammy wants to play. Only one player in the form of Regs sitting over towards that A site. He's just waiting for them to come along the far left-hand side of the map. They want to come through long A. He's in a good spot to finish him up, but it will be 3-1 if that's the case. We have seen one player in the form of, I think it was Willy KS, actually push out as well onto the far right-hand side of the map. We can see him here. And he's trying to perhaps lurk and find someone over on B. But I think it might be an A execute here, Elfish Guy.
Yeah, I mean, it's a little bit split up here from Jam. Obviously, they have Willy KS sitting here on plat, but not for too much longer, as Envy is able to molly him out of position and pick him up with the AWP there. Iron is going to pick up a Majestic, though, so trading back a kill. Still, this is going to be in the favor of Jam in a 4v3. And now Regs has a bit of work to do here on this A-bomb site. Will be able to pick up one. Yes, he will. Probably should have got two there, but Steve is going to come around from the short area to pick that kill up in very quick fashion and actually save a teammate. But regardless, now it's the retake here for Envy in a 2v1. He picks up one. Well, it was a 3v1. Now make it a 1v1 as he picks up Iron as well. Cruden will spot him out, though, and takes him down. So, oof, very close round coming out there. Cruden down to 20 HP, but in the end, it is Jam to close it up.
It certainly is in a very, very important first gun round, but massive economical damage going out across the board there, Jordan. It's not great for either team, but Jam's certainly going to appreciate the win. And that was a pretty good positioning as well from Cruden, just up there on top of the shack and find himself that last kill, almost guaranteeing him a kill, knowing that the player was down underneath him and would have had a very poor line of sight towards him. Four stack from the WinterWolves on the B site, thinking surely Jam Gaming are going to rush us over here eventually. Willie Case in a great spot out there on Terrace. He picks up a kill, changes out his weapon, I think, as well. No, he's still on that P90.
No, he just picked up a pistol, kill.
It's what it counts. P90, my favorite weapon, because I'm a Counter-Strike professional. That's what the P stands for. Picks up a second onto Envy, and not looking great here for the WinterWolves. Only three players left, and no real weapons to speak of. One CZ as Rex goes down as well. Willie gets another. Willie KS on three kills so far. He might be able to pick up the fourth. Probably not, because it's going to come out onto A side. Iron's going to get a free kill onto Extinct, and Jam Gaming picks up the second round after the gun round, and starting to get a little bit of momentum here. WinterWolves needs to get a buy-in.
Alrighty. So Jam starting to get a little bit out in front here. Willie is going to keep stick with that P90 in this round, and why not, when it worked out so well for him last round? Doesn't necessarily need to invest too much more money in to another weapon when the P90 is working out okay. And Jam just going for a default setup here, a bit of a split-style gameplay. They have a couple over towards B and a few over towards A. Iron actually going quite aggressive here on his own, and might get punished for it. Indeed, he will. Riggs is going to pick him up. Iron, that wasn't too good at all. Majestic and Pierce going to close out a couple more kills in the favor of WinterWolves. And unfortunately for Jam, that was really just everyone going in one by one and getting taken out in a duel. So they need to work on those trades perhaps a little bit. Now Envy are going to go for a peek up against Steve, and it is going to be Envy to pick that one up. Steve got the shot off first, but it certainly missed. And that's the important thing, I guess, in those AWP versus AWP matchups. Now 1v4 here for Cruden to deal with. He's got an AWP to deal with as well, and it's not going to work out too well for him as Envy closes out his second kill for the round, and WinterWolves put themselves at 10 on the board.
Envy not having a bad game in general. He's 17-15, going positive here in regs, going okay for his side at the moment. They need to bring this one back. I guess they have brought it back, to be fair. It's 10-11. Results so far haven't been great, but they will be able to finally get themselves another round here after losing two in a row. And a relatively good buy coming out from the T side, from both sides, to be fair. And it looks like we are finally going to get that that B execute. Only three players, though, from WinterWolves on this site, as all five players here from Jam Gaming starting to stack up along B main. Are they going to push out? Steve's, I think he's got a smoke going to go over the top. All the smokes executing onto the site at the moment. They should be able to push out Cruden. Needed to pick up that kill onto Pairs, but he won't be able to. He wanted to get around them, but at the moment, Extinct in a reasonable spot. He's going to go down. Willie K is going to get the kill. Envy in a very bad spot here with this orb. Someone's going to come up underneath. Oh. He picks up a free kill through the smoke, manages to pull himself away. Majestic goes down. Pairs onto one. He gets taken out by Iron. Regs onto Steven. Iron is the situation. The bomb plant is down. Iron does get one, and the bomb is going to I guess eventually blow up. We won't see it, but that's it. Jam Gaming picks up another round. That's back and forth, so economically not looking very good for WinterWolves here. Pick up a round, buying, and losing it all again, putting them in a pretty bad position. Jam looking like they're actually going pretty well now.
Yeah, it's been a pretty backwards and forwards half here. Three in a row for WinterWolves, and then two in a row for Jam, and then one apiece. So whether or not Jam can close out a second in a row here is going to be a good question. Obviously, they're up against an eco round, so they should theoretically have the advantage coming into this one, but I feel like the anti-ecos this game haven't been the best. So WinterWolves still in with a chance here.
Yeah, Jam trying to play this one perhaps carefully. A couple of players over towards the A site. Only one on the CT side defending over on B, but the bomb at the moment is up towards mid. So Regs in a reasonable spot here, finds a free kill. He does, should be able to pick up an AK if he is careful, and he does do that as well. He's now 4-4. Three players going to slide out here through B main onto the site. Extinct going to go down there from Willie KS, but a love of the MAC-10. And bomb plant should go down as well if the bomb comes around. Reasonable time. Almost good timing there for Willie KS, but he does pick up Envy anyway. Bomb plant coming down from Steve. 4-2. and not a great situation here for the
Vines. Nice shot from
on
Steve.
The CT side. Steve getting himself a free kill onto Pairs. Steve having a reasonable game as well. And Reg's going to try and hold his AK, I think. And I don't even know if he wants any extra frags. He just wants to keep his team in the competition. Because Jam Gaming back, storming forward here. They will pick up two in a row, Elfish Guy. And putting themselves in a great position. 13-10 will be the score, only needing three more rounds. With WinterWolves not looking very good economically.
Yeah, I think Jam here can probably try and hunt down Regs here. And if it's Willy KS to be the one to do it with the MAC-10, that's going to probably be the best possible result. He's not going to get it there. So not too bad in the end there for Jam, because Willy probably would have been rebuying a weapon anyway, because obviously he doesn't want to take the SMG into a gun round here. But it certainly would have been a lot better for Jam if they were able to pick up that kill there. But regardless, Regs is going to be able to take that AK into the next round here. There is a CZ on the side of Majestic, but apart from that, WinterWolves have a pretty reasonable buy coming out here, and it's going to be a difficult round for Jam.
Oh, that was a great nade iron. Very, very well done to the back of the head of your teammate. It's what we love to see. It's fantastic. But Jam Gaming going to flash out here towards A site. And upstairs they will go. They're going to try and swing around to long. I'm not sure. Only one player in the form of Rex trying to hold this side of the map. He finds himself one free kill. No, Cruden, sorry, finds himself a free kill. Rex, though, should be able to do the same. Picks up one, turns around. There's a player either side. So he's not going to be able to find a second. Nice little trade out coming there from Jam Gaming. Goes, picks up Pairs onto the A site. They go. It is open. One player trying to keep the CT side on the B half of the map, and he should be able to. The bomb plant going to go down. And, yeah, it looks like Cruden not in a bad spot here to try and stop this rotation and take down the rest of WinterWolves. His plant, will he get the second? He shouldn't, because he gets caught out by Envy. Didn't expect two players to be there at once. Another round going to go over to Jam here on the T side. And Envy, the last player left, going to try and keep that AK. But Jam Gaming going to bring this out to a 14-10 lead, and Elfish Guy starting to look all too hard here for the WinterWolves.
Certainly is. And Jam, even if they lose probably the next round, they're going to have enough money to buy in the following round. So looking quite good for them to be able to close this out as we head in towards, you know, the late map situations here. Having a look at the economy, though, for WinterWolves, it's going to be a little tough. They haven't got a whole lot of money here. And if they want to force into this one, so that they can avoid that 15th round for Jam, it's going to be a less than ideal buy. Don't know if they're actually going to be doing it at the moment. It looks like they're just saving, just buying some pistols and saving. So it looks like they can go for the overtime here. I guess hoping perhaps against hope that Envy might be able to do something with this AK here, but really putting all of their eggs into the next round more than anything.
They certainly are. Interestingly enough, I think Jam have been okay with these anti-ecos. They're just sort of trying to prepare for any sort of rush, any sort of cheese coming out from the guys in WinterWolves. And so far, they played it pretty well, to be perfectly honest. Bomb at the moment just down in hall, just waiting. Two players from Jam heading towards B. Looks like two as well trying to slide towards A, but they will start making their way through halls onto the B bomb side, Elfish Guy. And again, it looks like, we're going to see a first kill coming out from Pairs, actually. So Willy K is going to go down. So they don't want to throw too much away. 4-4 is the player count, but B-bomb site is going to be the rush.
Yeah, they're going to just charge out here, I think. Deciding to just slow down for the moment there. Iron is going to take down Majestic there. And, oh, Cruden jumping down right behind Pairs. Perfect positioning, and this should be an easy round in the bag now for Jam, putting them on 15, and WinterWolves, you know, they're going to have enough money in next round to buy up a little bit, but still going to be tough heading into this. They're going to have to win 5 in a row, and then OT if they want to take out this one. If not, it's probably going to be them getting knocked out.
Yeah, it's not a great position, certainly, but you're just trying to make it into that. Single elimination playoff bracket for the top teams later. So it's not like we've got 128 teams sitting here. If they can pick up their third game of the day on Nuke, that may be okay. So we'll see how they go. Depends on the the other results, obviously. But look, it's not a great position, to be fair. So, obviously, we've been following this group through for a little while, Jam Gaming. I think we're going to see them up next against Chiefs. Is that what it was?
That's what I've been told.
Yeah, onto Nuke. So, that'll be interesting, certainly, to see how Nuke plays out if any of these teams have done any strats. I think they will have known the maps for a little while. Steve going to find himself a first kill as Majestic. Pokes out onto A-Main there, and Elfish Guy, this is it's not looking great for WinterWolves.
Certainly not, but a 4v4 situation is better than perhaps it could have been. Reg's down to 19 HP, so he could have very easily been out of the game as well. 3 versus 4 could have been a potential situation here, but Jam not quite managing to close out that kill there, and now just playing it slow, waiting here to see whether or not WinterWolves are going to make a mistake. And at the moment, WinterWolves not giving them a whole lot, sitting on their sights and playing safe, but Jam eventually are going to have to make their move, and this could potentially be the round that closes out the map for them.
It certainly could. We have 1 minute left on the clock. They are holding strong here on the T side, but with 4 players only on the CT, it's a little bit more difficult to hold. You got to spread yourself a little bit thinner across the map. 2 on to B, 2 on to A. Steve trying to poke out here through Terrace with his AWP on through long A even, and Envy holding here with his. He will pick up Willy KS, free kill there for him. Nice little shot on the AWP, and it will make it a little bit easier. I don't know if they really want to execute onto this A side if there's only 2 of them. I guess we'll see. Pears picks himself up a kill as well. So with only Ghost left with an AWP, only Ghost left to die, and WinterWolves picks up the round and takes this into round 27, I would suspect. And we're getting there. They've got to win the next 5, though, Jordan. That's a big ask.
Well, they got to win the next 4 and then head into overtime. So, yeah, that is a big ask. But obviously, they've got a better buy now. They're looking a little bit more stable, economically speaking. And Jam, they've got 5 AKs, no AWP this time, and just making their way towards the B area and seeing whether or not they can get anything done there. They do have a player just lagging behind a little bit, but it does seem like all 5 members of Jam are heading towards the B side. And this is probably going to be an execute. Let's have a look. Yeah, a few of them setting up smokes here as well. So they're just getting basically everything they can and trying to lock down this round as best as they can. Here comes the smokes.
Onto the site. They will fly out now. Oh, nice kill coming out from Envy. That's what they needed. WinterWolves still with 5 players up as Pairs goes down, making it a 4-on-2-3. And Bomb has been dropped on the site. Prudent picks up 1. Ghost goes down as well. 3-3 is the player count. Extinct with a great spray. Will he get a second? He does. Oh. Down to 12 HP. Iron in the head. Steve in the head. Great play from him. But Cruden is the last player. It looks like WinterWolves will be able to find themselves another round. It might be 12-on-2-15 as just the 1 player left. Actually, we have seen Regs push all the way out onto A. I don't know if that was necessarily needed here, but it doesn't matter. Majestic takes out Cruden. And 12-15, WinterWolves picking up another round. A bit of cash, though, however, for Jam Gaming. We'll see. I would suspect they should be able to buy here. They will start buying up 1 AK, 2 AKs. There's 3. And only Ghost to buy. There's 5 AKs, a bunch of armor, all with helmets as well, Elfish Guys. So it's not a terrible situation. But WinterWolves, this is what they need to do. 1 round after the other. That's all we can ask for them if they want to bring this one back. And that's slowly what they've been doing.
Well, things getting a little bit nervous for Jam, though. They were sort of steamrolling for a little bit there, 4 rounds in a row, but now all of a sudden they've essentially hit the brick wall. That is the WinterWolves. 2 rounds in a row, things have not gone their way, and a little bit of doubt might be starting to creep into their minds. They'll be thinking, what do we do now? We've tried to execute on B, and nothing else seems to be working, so we'll just go for a bit of a split at the moment. See if we can pick someone off here. Envy peeking right into the line of Steve. If he had an AWP, he might have been able to pick up that kill there, but the AK not quite enough in that situation. You're only getting him down to 22 HP. Still, it's better than nothing. And the advantage early in this round, slightly in the favor of Jam.
Will, the bomb starts to make its way over to the A side of the map. Jam still with all their players remain, as of course are the WinterWolves, and holding just one player in the form of Willie KS over on that towards dropping the B side. He might be able to find himself one or two free kills if he's very, very lucky. But the smoke's going to start raining down on the A side. We'll see the execute come out here in a second. I suspect free kill onto Envy. Reg takes out Kroon and Willie KS onto Pans as well. Reg's in a reasonable spot. Bomb goes down. It's dropped. Regs takes out one pack. Will he get the second iron? Finally going to find that kill. It is 2-1. Iron the last player left for his team. He might be able to get one. He does, but he needs to come back and get the second. 1-1. Iron in a relatively poor spot. And Extinct saves the day, but that was closer than I suspect it needed to be, Elfish Guy. Real Elfish Guy mute is real. Alright, a little bit of a weird audio, but we'll just go with it. Apparently matches can end in draws as well, so that is interesting. And they brought this one back so very far. 15-14 is the score, and it's going to be very, very close. We'll see what the end result is for these guys. Look, it's going to be close. I think football's good. They can at least bring this one back to the score. Plenty on the top. We'll find out in a second what the situation is and how this one is going to go and play out. Very, very close it is. The bomb is down in the halls. They've certainly looked over there. 3 onto the A side, 2 over to the B side of the map. And Elvish Guy, have I got you back?
Have you got me back?
I do. It's great to hear.
Nice.
Yeah.
I was really disappointed that you couldn't hear me because I really enjoyed casting that last round. But regardless, heading into this one, it'll be 14-15 in the favor of Jam at the moment, trying to close this one out. As you mentioned, it can be a tie situation. So basically everything on the line here for WinterWolves and Jam, they're going to be disappointed if this one goes to a tie. They had so many opportunities to close out this map. We'll have to see what happens. Iron is going to get a great entry frag. Willie KS as well, finding one, but a double response coming out from WinterWolves, making it a triple actually as Envy closes out Steve. It's a 2v3 situation here. WinterWolves looking poised to take it to 15-15. But still a couple of players left for Jam to try and make something of it. Kruden will take down Extinct. Envy now has a job to do. The smoke comes down to block off his vision. Actually, the plant in the smoke here from Kruden. What a man. And he's actually going to get out of there alive. Envy walking in. He's not going to defuse as you try and yell out there. But it is going to be Ghost to close out Envy there. And now Majestic in a 1v2. Well, maybe the defuse might have been a better option. But I dare say he would have gone down in the end there. And Kruden is going to close out the final kill there onto Majestic. Very fitting considering Kruden was one of the better players for Jam in that game. And wow, 16-14 the result there in the favor of Jam. What a game,
man. That was so